What's up, guys? Today's video is sponsored by Current. Current is a mobile banking app and Visa debit card that offers so many unique features you've probably never heard of. Current keeps it authentic and direct. No holds back, no hidden fees. They've got tech that banks should have been building years ago. Imagine pulling up your banking app and actually seeing things that help you, things that'll save you money and ways to earn points, easy access to ATMs and so much more. You pull up the Current app on your phone, you can see all the places they offer cash back when you shop there. You head there, you earn points, and you redeem them all on your phone through Current's app. One feature I really like is they have customizable saving pods. Put money away for purchases you're making in the future, say some car parts. Spending insights, instant notifications. Heck, you can even get your paycheck days early if you're set up with their direct deposit. And it takes less than 2 minutes to sign up if you use my link, which is current.com/Cleetus, and it's also in the description below. Better yet, guys, Current is giving away $5,000 if you use coupon code Cleetus at checkout. So they're actually giving $500 to 10 of you guys. I like the special offer to our subscribers specifically. Shout out to Current for sponsoring today's video. Let's get to the live action.
Hell yeah. Yeah, brother, you're on the Cleetus McFarland YouTube channel.
Well, boys, I sold the mini squirt. It was short-lived, but this thing has just been kind of sitting around because obviously we got the mini jet and the jet stream. So she's been sitting around. It's such a good little boat. I didn't want to see it rot away, so got her sold. She is heading to Tennessee. Hopefully you guys will see it out sometime. I'm sure the new owner will make some videos on YouTube and stuff, but been a good little boat. All right. There she goes. Till next time, Squirt. We'll see you around. What's the deal with this puppy? I heard y'all did some wastegate welding. Ooh.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Ooh. Dang.
Just kind of welded the V-band to the V-band.
I see that.
You
know,
we ain't got time for no games.
Ain't no need. I see Ty might have helped on that deal.
Oh, yeah. Then Jack Stan did the back one. Look what he did with his wire.
Where? Oh.
Got me good.
Classic Jack Stan move.
Classic Jack Stan.
So this is ready to go. So maybe we test it today while we're doing some drifting?
Yeah, it doesn't have any reference lines, so it's just a little boost leak. Rodney, don't care about
put it on wastegate, dude. Let's see what it'll make. All right, cool. Looking good, dude. Old Rodney's going to be back today.
He's going to be back. You cannot wait.
Fire me up. You got some burners on it? All right, cool. Ready to rip. All right, so guys, during my time with the Rona, I was at my house power cleaning. And I found a totaled lawnmower in my yard, a mower deck, so much crap laying around. There's side-by-sides everywhere, parked all over the yard, a roof to a van. I mean, there's literally crap everywhere. There's tires floating in the pond. And I just went on a freaking cleaning spree, cleaning things up. We just have so much crap laying around. And it's not that we need to sell stuff. It's just that there's things that are rotting out in the Florida sun. So I am trying to just get rid of stuff, including the squirt. We're getting rid of the squirt. I'm getting rid of the mud truck. I mean, there's junk everywhere. And it's not that I don't want it or don't like it. It's just, I don't want to see it rot because we have so much other stuff going on and other things that we're using. So at this point, if it's not running, we need to get it running. And if it is running and we have no use for it, I think we need to get rid of it. I don't want to just collect stuff and have it sit. So I got the Dale truck up and running this weekend. I got the C7 going, which you're going to see in this video. Stuff that's all just been sitting around. It's time to get it going. Dude, our trees absolutely cooked. Got to update our trees. The Marauder, good to go. We even got Chief fixed. So I'm just trying to get everything top-notch, dialed in, and actually usable. You know what I mean? We need some usable things. And then I also got to get the toter home going this week. I got to make sure everything's good with that. We have like 6 events in a row that the toter home is going to have to go to. So that thing's about to get some miles put on it. I don't know when you're supposed to change oil on a brand new Freightliner, but I got to look into that too. All right, guys, so Georgie and I went to my house to grab a C7. It's been having some problems. The other day I was driving it from the shop in Clearwater and it overheated and oil got really hot and the oil pressure was really low. So not an ideal situation. I was just cruising, literally cruising over the bridge and just like started getting hot. It was like 250 degree water temp. So I pulled over, let it cool down, and then drove it home, and it was just not the greatest oil pressure. Dang. So really hoping I didn't hurt it or nothing, but we'll see. It was fine for a while and started having issues. The oil pressure's pretty good right now, cruising, but it's also still a little cold. So we'll just cut open the oil filter and see what's going on. But this thing's dirty, so we're gonna get it washed up real quick. Get it cleaned up, pull it to the new shop. Tell you what, still pulls hard. didn't get hot on this drive. The mud divers got on my throttle body. They went right through the vent. Think about that. Alright, cool. I mean, it is a built for.
You want that on these hot rod motors.
Well, god dang.
She ain't been this clean in ages.
She don't idle real good, huh?
No, that either.
Oh, really? I kind of like the mud dauber nest on the throttle body.
Think about it. Is that just clear coat it, leave it?
Yeah. Well, let's get this sucker lifted up in the air. I want to cut this filter open and make sure these bearings are good. Because I saw some not so great oil pressure the other day. You know what I'm saying? When I overheated it, not good. Not a drop of oil on my finger. They say it couldn't be done. Gonna learn today, boy. Oh shit, it's hot. Oh god, dang. Oh, look at that. Oh. I got a little bit. Yeah, I mean, doesn't look stellar. Probably should have changed it a little earlier, you know.
A little sooner, but you know.
I feel like Parker Mitchell on race week. I've always been a fan of these doohickeys because they tell you what you need to know, but also they can really deliver some bad news, you know what I'm saying? All of a sudden you're having a good day, you're like, ah, I'm gonna cut open this filter. And the next thing you know, you're not having so good of a day. Really hoping this goes the right way for me today, George.
It's gonna go one way or the other, that's for sure.
I mean, boys, there's a little bit of something, but I mean, I've seen an engine with tore up bearings. I don't think this is it. I mean, see that little bit of stuff, but like, this was like the first big couple of drives was on this filter.
Oh, dude.
Like, we're in the green, dude. I'd say we're about 90% in the green.
In Florida, that thing is what you call clean as a whistle.
I think she just got a little hot, but we'll show you why. So, this is the oil cooler right here. Big dog, weighs 30 pounds. But we had it right here. And then this was covering the cooler. Wasn't working out. So the oil was getting hot, coolant's getting hot. We're gonna try and move some stuff around, maybe just ditch, like, see this crap, see these rubber things. We're gonna take these out, take this top shroud out, because basically, I mean, only the only open part of this is down here, and that's this tube for the intercooler. So all around, didn't do a great job designing our cooling on the C7. I mean, Chevy did, but then we ruined it.
That's what redesigning is for.
I mean, really, I think we can leave the oil cooler there. I think we just need to open all this crap up and not limit it. I mean, it's just like a heat sink. And then we should go rip it. See you later, nerd. Oh. Oh, my God. That's just wrong, dude. Why do these silly little flying creatures have to do this to the C7? All right, George's putting some air in the tires. We got her oiled up. We're gonna let it rip. All right, so airflow is still not really optimal, but you can see the radiator now, which is an actual upgrade. So still got some bugs on the front of this thing, but we'll get it cleaned up a little more. We're gonna take it out for a rip, see if it overheats. Go for a quick rip. You never been in the Bald Eagle machine, have you, Georgie?
Not unless you weren't at the shop.
Oh, dang. Oh, stole it after hours? All right, let's go try this sucker out. We got a fire going here. A lot of brush out here at the new shop.
That's a good one.
Yeah, dude, that's a spicy one.
Yeah, right next to the trees.
Well, I mean, it just rained, so hopefully the trees don't burn. I got this one going, too.
Hey, dude.
I know. Then I'm going to come do those boxes later. All right, let's go warm this thing up. This road.
Pretty rough.
We really got to redo the road coming into the shop, guys. It's El Camino, scrape city. C7's not that bad, actually. Yeah. Oh,
Shot right up to him. Feels good.
I mean, it's fast. But then did you hear it breaking up a little bit?
Yeah. I wonder if it's spraying meth like it should. You ever seen that light come on or off?
Oh, yeah, the light's on.
Okay.
It's spraying meth.
Oil pressure's still chilling. I mean, for 1400 RPM. It's not bad. Temps 210, water temps 200. It's not like outrageous, but not good. So what do we do? I mean, I say for starters, we move that, put an intake elbow on it.
Yeah, for sure.
So the filter is getting some decent air. I mean, maybe we could even try and get a fresh air pickup over here. That might be about half our problem right there. What do you think?
I think the other half is the radiator being blocked.
Yeah, but what do we do? Where do we put the condenser, the oil cooler?
I'm thinking, well, condenser's got to stay. I'm thinking the oil cooler kind of over in the corner, like you said.
Yeah.
And then the heat exchanger, like maybe lay it down flat, maybe slap a fan on it even.
Yeah, that might be the trick. All right. Well, guys, C7, you know, we're going to have to make some... We're going to have to make some changes to this puppy. Something ain't right. It's basically undrivable over, you know, a long distance. Or if it's a cool night, I mean, it has no issues. But if I'm driving it like 20, 30 minutes on a hot Florida summer day, it's just this hell no brother and just starts overheating.